A lot of the pamphlets I get through my letterbox are what I would call missed opportunities, or if I want to be a little more unkind, a waste of resources. Somebody spent all that time, effort, and cost writing and designing and printing it, sending it out, and delivering it to my door, all for me to just do this. Well, I'd normally recycle them, but you get my point. It's sad, isn't it? Unless a pamphlet is serving some kind of value to me, they're really just bits of paper that go through the whole life cycle just to get put in a bin. Stick around and I'll show you how to make pamphlets worth keeping. Hi, I'm Elise. I'm a software engineer in the print team here at Canva. Pamphlets, sometimes called brochures, are a great way to grab your audience's attention and leave them with something that they can refer back to. And this is what most people forget when designing pamphlets. It can't just be a dressed up leaflet. Ah, what's the difference between a leaflet and a pamphlet? I'm glad you've asked. Leaflets are generally smaller than pamphlets, often one-sided and on a single page rather than folded, and have a more impermanent nature. Pamphlets are meant to be kept, normally the drawdown in your kitchen, and referred back to when needed. They can also be folded in all sorts of ways. Using a standard paper size, they can be folded in half, landscape or portrait, giving you four separate panels where you can place your content. Or you can fold it down the middle, what's often referred to as a DL fold. This will give you a very long, thin pamphlet in landscape or portrait. And more commonly, they include three folds. Here you can have a Z fold, sometimes called a concertina fold. And you'll see there are now six panels where your information could go. You could also fold it this way, giving you a trifold, good for hiding and then revealing things to the viewer when they open it up. And then you can have a roll fold, which gives you eight panels, or an accordion fold. Oh, okay, you get the picture. There are a lot of different folds you could use. And all of this is to really show you the main difference between a leaflet and a pamphlet. It's all about the way information is delivered to the audience. A leaflet is just front and back, whereas a pamphlet can keep things from the audience, asking them to first engage with the outer content before revealing the hidden parts inside. It's really quite romantic. Anyway, you didn't come to listen to me talk wistfully about folds. Check out my other video for that, 45 minutes of fold talk. No, I'm just kidding. Let's get into some design. Okay, the easiest way to start is with a template. We call it starting inspired. The search results will have all sorts of pamphlet folds, so I'm going to make it a little more targeted. If you hover over one of them, you can see how many pages it has, and it will show you a preview if you keep hovering. Okay, I need a client to design for. Oh, nice. Market stories are perfect for pamphlets. Often the attendees are on holiday or traveling, so being able to hand them a pamphlet means that they can get back in touch to repurchase or follow your website and socials. I'll start with this template. This only has one side, or two panels, so I'll add another page by hitting this button. Now I have four panels. This will be the front cover. This will be the back. And this will be the inside spread. Oh, I like this font. Let's call the market stall Sasha's Soap. And I'll use this shape as well. Change what's inside. That font's a little heavy, so I'll choose something else. You can type in what you're looking for here, or if you already know the font name, you could just search it. That's better. You can find images of soap over here in the Elements tab. Anything with a crown on it is for Pro and Canva for Teams users. Anything without it is free. Although you could purchase a Pro image as a one-time purchase. If you're going to use a few Pro images, you're probably better off subscribing. Then everything is open to you. Alternatively, you could hit this button and filter for only free images. Or more likely, you'll want to upload your own photos here. Okay, strap in and turn the music up. I'm gonna do some speed designing. Love these line illustrations. I found one with the search term flower sketch, and then I found the others by clicking on the See More Like This button. Gorgeous, aren't they? Okay, this is looking pretty good, but if I'm honest with myself, where's the value? Why would customers want to keep this? Think about it, the longer they hold this pamphlet, the more chance they have of repurchasing. If you have an idea about what I could add, let me know in the comments. Oh, these are some great suggestions. Alrighty, time to get busy. On the cover, I could add a subhead that taps into their unique selling proposition. This 100% is taking up a lot of room, so I'll move it here and use this to put a special offer in with a code. Okay, that's a reason to pick it up and take it. On the back, I could go into more detail about our values, maybe even show these through icons. I just searched in the Elements tab and found these. On the inside, I'm going to resize some things and give me more space and add in more details about specific soaps. This will help with the decision-making process. Everyone likes a story. Here, I'll put some information they can refer to get the most out of their purchase. And down here, I'll add something about the owners, a reason to believe their authentic mission. To print this, I can just go to the share menu. Select the finish. Select how many. It's that easy. In no time at all, they'll be turning up at my door. Wow, look at the colors. Oh, now that is something worth keeping a hold of. Okay, I'm running out of time, but I want to show you how to create a trifold pamphlet. Actually, there's a great video with my friends Joe and Maddie all about that. So instead, I'll show you how to make a Z-fold pamphlet. They are very similar. It's really about where you put the information. Begin with a blank pamphlet. The easiest way to do this is grab a trifold template and delete everything. This will be the front, so here I will add the logo. Some tempting dishes. Maybe an illustration or two. Okay, that's good enough to pick up. On a Z fold, the back cover will be here. This is where I need to put information about how to get in contact and what services are offered. To give this retention value, I'll add in a price list here. A mouth-watering image. A reason to believe here. And some more examples of dishes. Nice! I think this is ready. It's so simple. I could follow the print processes before, and when they turn up, I'm ready to start serving customers. Wow, I'm getting hungry. When's lunch? Let me know if you have questions in the comments. Did you find this video helpful? If the answer's yes, make sure you like and subscribe to our channel before you head off. We release new videos weekly and I'd hate for you to miss out. In fact, you could check out some of them now. Here's one of my faves. I hope you enjoy it. Thanks for watching.